In this segment, we'll talk about what the definition of eigenvalues and eigenvectors is. So if we have, if A is a square matrix, is an n by n matrix, then if we look at a vector x and we say it's not equal to 0, is an eigenvector, of A if A times X is equal to lambda times X. So if you have a square matrix and you find out, hey, there is a vector, a column vector, which is not a zero vector, and if that satisfies this particular condition here, that A times X is equal to lambda times X, then X is called the eigenvector of A, and lambda is the eigenvalues. And of course, lambda is a scalar, so it's just a number. So that's how we define eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So all you have to do is you have to find a vector, a column vector, which is non-zero, such that when you multiply it to the A matrix, that it turns out to be some number times the eigenvector itself, or this vector, column vector X itself. And whatever that scalar is by which you are multiplying it so that this equality is held good is called an eigenvalue. So lambda is the eigenvalue. So you can get different eigenvalues for a n by n matrix. So if you have a n by n matrix, you'll get n eigenvalues. And corresponding to each eigenvalue, you'll have an eigenvector. So n by n matrix has n eigenvalues, which we may call as lambda 1, lambda 2, all the way up to lambda n. So they're not necessarily going to be unique, but we'll have n different eigenvalues. And corresponding to each eigenvalue, you will have an eigenvector. So those are things which we have to think about when we talk about what it means for a particular square matrix to have eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And that's the end of this segment.